Good night.
Chuggity chug.
As fuck.
Alright. Happy Homebrew Wednesday to all the YouTube viewers out there. Today I'm going to do something a little different. I'm not going to brew any wine or anything. I've got a couple videos on Backstash ready to go. So you notice I'm not doing everything on a freezer. One of them went out. The other one was moved to a different location, so I've got this table set up here. So now everyone can see what I'm doing in front of me, which is a big deal, I guess. It's a big difference anyway. It's a big deal for me, I guess. Anyway, the first thing we're going to do is try some wine. This wine here was made by my uncle. And he was the one that got me into homebrewing. He's the one that kind of showed me how it was done and what, you know, processes and steps I needed to take to make it happen. You know, showed me quite a bit and what I needed to do to get, you know, get into that world. So, yeah. Cheers to him. So this is, you can smell it, it's blackberry. The label fell off, but that's all right. Smells good. It's definitely got that blackberry taste to it. Alright, today we're going to do something a little different. I've been thinking about doing a filler for my carboys because, you know, I've done my second racking, and of course once the sediment gets out of there and stuff, it gets a little bit lower on the carboy and you need to fill it back up, get that headspace. Now, the catch behind it is, you know, how are you going to fill it back up? Which, you know, a lot of people got a lot of different methods. You know, some people, they use marbles, which is alright, I mean, I'd probably suggest it if you're using a plastic carboy. I've got glass, so I really don't want to go that route without really, you know, I would hate to lose 6 gallons of water dropping a marble in there and having an accident. You know, somebody may comment on it and say, hey, I've done it for years and water, you know, whatever works for you. And then other people, they'll add straight water into it, just put water in it, which I've kind of, you know, you do the mathematics behind it, of course it's going to dilute your wine, it's not going to have the alcohol content you want. Now other people, you know, risk to catch vodka. I'm not going to go, you know, too crazy on it, but, you know, they'll put vodka in it, make it a little stronger, you know. It's, but, you know, however you do it, it's okay. But the way I prefer to do it is try and get an alcohol content near what my wine is. And, well, I've done the mathematics behind it. And anyway, today I'm going to make 1 gallon of 13.75% alcohol by volume water. So, first thing you need to do, get your gallon jug, empty gallon jug, and go ahead and get your measuring cup. Now, considering we're using vodka, you know, it's pretty much sanitized itself here. And this plastic lid. Oh, man. All right. So what we're going to do here is I made it real simple. I did the mathematics all the way down to the point that you just got to remember one number. Damn, that's in there now. Now I'm going to simply just add my water. Bam. All right. There you go. Real simple method. Now, put this aside. Now, it's a good idea to always mark your containers when you go along and do stuff. I always do. I use plastic containers. They're cheaper than glass. If I have a 1 gallon carboy, I don't want to use it on cleaning solution and stuff. You know, they say, you know, you stuff 1 or 2 glasses in glass. So I just switch them out every 3 to 6 months. Star sand every week, of course, but what I'm going to do here, make it real easy, I'm going to mark it 13.75. Now, I have a filler that ain't going to dilute my wine, but it ain't going to make it too strong. It's going to put it where it needs to be, which, you know, most of my wine is either 12.5 to 15, so this is a real good marker of where I need to be and where I want, you know, if I want to keep my wine where I want it to be, that's a good way of accomplishing it.
So there we go. There's my bottles of wine, or carboys full of wine. The first one being peach, blackberry, raspberry, or mixed berry, and mixed berry with concentrates. You haven't seen the video on that because it's one of those that are on reserve. You know, I like to kind of have a couple stacked up so that way if I miss something one week, you know, I've got something to post. It makes sense. But here we go. This one's the one I just went along and pumped out a couple days ago, and I need to go along and add the headspace. So I'm going to go ahead and do that now. And bam, there we go. Been added up. It's where I like it. It's comfortable. And I know the alcohol content isn't far off from what it was to start with.
Alright, so now that I got that done, I'm going to go ahead and put the link in the description below. So that way you know where to go if you want to go along and make your own mix. Maybe you want something a little different, a little bit, you know, different alcohol content or whatever. Alright, I also wanted to put out there today that I went along and I bought a new book, which I buy books occasionally for winemaking or whatever. But this one, The Homebuilt Winery by Steve Hughes, has 43 projects that you can build for winemaking equipment. So, you know, if you're the little guy or, you know, you're planning on getting bigger or whatever, which, you know, I think I'm content with no more than 6 carboys going at one time. That's a lot. That's probably enough for at least half the year right there. Well, maybe a year. I don't know. Maybe I'm slightly an alcoholic. I don't know. But you gotta be to enjoy this craft. I don't see anyone not drinking their wine after they make it, which, I don't know. I'd be scared to drink your wine if you didn't want to drink it after you made it. It's just, but here's, you know, an example. Here's a wine press that could be made. I hope y'all can see it. I don't know. But, you know, they got a wine press in here, which I think is going to be one of my projects. I'll probably make it as a Homebrew Wednesday or something. But I got to find a little bit of time for it. But it has a little bit of everything in here. It has, you know, how to make racking canes, how to make your own hydrometer, how to, you know, make your own bung stuffer, whatever you want to call them, your bungs, how to, you know, make dollies for your barrels, and how to make lifts for your, you know, whatever you want to lift, you know, your barrels, whatever, whatever. Also shows you how to make a, you know, a rinser in here. It also shows you how to make a filter, everything you would ever need, so you don't have to go to your brewery store and buy the expensive, you know, $300 item or $200 item. You can make it here yourself for about $50. You know, you cut a lot of money out if you go along and make it yourself, which I have the tools, I have the equipment, I have the know-how, so more than likely that's the direction I'm going to go. But I was going to go ahead and give this guy a shout-out, Steve Hughes. He made a great book. So anyone out there, you know, that's looking to, you know, build up their winery and do it with their own equipment and not have to spend all that money, this is the book for you. Go ahead and check it out. I'll keep brewing if you keep viewing. Cheers. Drunk, yes, fuck. He's drunk as fuck.